come to an end. It's time to choose. It's time to unchoose. But as for me and my house, we choose to serve the Lord. And as for me and my family, we will honor the Lord.
Jacob says,
I have been delayed by being in the presence of
Laban. But I have all that I have. But when I think about this, I should be very far.
Now I return to my place. I'll hand over to my brother, but let me just be translucent to you concerning the text. I'm going back to where I met God. It's time,
Mount Zion,
to return where we met the God.
As
we are in the Golo, it was
that we were taken from.
Uchagobe
says,
I am returning in the space, the place, and the spot where I met the Lord, running away from my brother.
When have you been where you met God?
What in the experience?
When
your experience such that rendezvous occurrences, when last?
Then he was.
I've been delayed.
If I was in the presence,
I am returning into the space of experience with God. Ladies and gentlemen, if we're gonna make it big in life, we must return to the place where we said, "Come into my heart."
We need to go back to the place that God has prayed.
If you cannot just sleep like ordinary woman, wake up and pray. I have everything, but everything is nothing without God being a thing in everything.
Not
to Canaan without Jehovah is Egypt. Not to Egypt without Jehovah is Canaan. So the issue is not the geographical placement, is the presence of God. God must say Canaan upon the Jehovah. He can't live by Egypt. When last you visited the place, we are in a madolo. We are in a why did you forsake the place? We share a leanto, a big bamba, pelling canugo, who pelaba fan and season, Pramatomazanet, who pelling mal and season, putting a funaway. Gosian Yasona, Pileanto. Why and Zan Ileanto? Everyone's a mouth, his son, who call him his son. I want to confess, Yasho Elamaya. Why Pulalangan Leanto? Every Kuluma Guanu, don't dress like this. Dress like this. Yashona Pilebinia Zakue. Iguenza Uchiga stopping. Would I did not pray today? So we bet if on my part, he won't let Yako, I part this Kama Sako, Uchiga would know something is missing. Uchuano, I did not pray and cry to my. Why exile?
What have you done with that thing? Let me revive that. That's what caused the delays in your life. You remember when you received Jesus?
The revival you heard.
The revival.
You were hungry to pray. You
want
to be in the presence of yourself.
The things that you came for is to snatch a son coming where I have seen the staircase
from earth to heaven. I am going there again where I heard the voice. I'm going there again where I woke up and I saw the gateway to heaven. It's where I am going again where I began to speak.
lukhuluma khona
ngeyilangiphindela
what have delayed me.
Sophisticated. Says he better to advance. Some shia.
And we have left him. My soul is crying. Let us go back to him. We are his.
Says us too much.
We know too much.
And not famous to him.
God has to me.
To the place where I met him.
And when
I've got to go back to the days where I used to kneel before him.
And cried, but I could feel him. Not eating, not because I want money, because I'm hungry for him.
Today,
to Jehovah, like an eagle, I'm doing so. Just like an eagle, I'm going back.
Where I met God. Do you remember your meeting? That occasion of your meeting.
What happened? Because the one that you met is still existing.
Now,
and you are still existing.
But why this
condition? The one that you met, he's still meeting others. But the person he doesn't meet is you.
I've got to go back where I met him.
What's gonna make it happen
is to meet him again. You met people and you are broken. You gave them your life and you are broken. You regret why I met her.
And
you regret why did he come across
you.
You regret why I was born in that family. But I don't hear you regretting why you lost contact with God. Why have you forsaken me?
You have met yourself only. This is the thing that have delayed us.
We know too much of ourselves and less of him. That's why we lose ourselves.
He came to the disciples and asked, what are the people say I am? Then he said, what do you say I am?
You are the Christ.
Peter said, Christ.
Son of the living God.
Jesus said, stop Peter. Since you have known me. It is the time for you to know yourself. You are Peter.
You
won't be called Simon.
If you want to know yourself, you must know him first. He will introduce you to yourself. If you want to know yourself from yourself by yourself, you will never know who you are.
You
never made yourself. There is a man who made you. That can make you know yourself better than you know yourself now. My fortitude, with all my ebullience, with all my strength, tenacity, resilience,
I
made up my mind. It's time I go back.
Everything
that I have,
without
him. Vanity of vanity. I have observed under the planet earth that everything on earth is nothing if God's not in the thing. You've been delayed far long. You missed your fellowship
with
God.
Turning
over to my apostle.
But
I want to beg you from the heart of your heart.
Will
you please remember God? Stop using God for your selfish desires. Stop controlling God for your own vaunting ambitions. And begin to love him for what he is.
More than
what he can give. Will you please come out of your selfishness and desire him and him alone. Jacob says, I'm going back to the place where I met him. I've been cheated on the way. Because I forsaken the place of meeting. I've seen things and faced things in life. I almost died because I forsaken the man I met. So for me now to leave, I must remit the man. I must meet him again.
I know you are discouraged.
I know you feel weak. But if you can return to him, he will surely return to you. Call unto me. I will answer. Call. And I will show you. I'm begging you. Stop playing hide and seek. Stop sleeping around. Stop booking hotels and lodges. And men. You can book one hotel. Just that you miss him.
Put
down
to be home.
I'm booking myself out.
I keep a car.
Until the morning. But the housekeeping,
when they are knocking the housekeeping, they're going to find you sleeping prostrate. Yet you are the one who's
let us return to the experience of falling in love with him. Let us return.
What makes the church to be in groups
that
quarrel with the men of God?
It
because you are not here for the thing that
we came to the church.
We are people of news. Yes, we are people of prayer. We are people of him. But now we belong to such people.
You
are not in that group
anywhere. We have not come to be Abaga Apollo and Abaga Paul.
As we are not for Johan, but we are his. I'm begging you.
Time to play sin is over. Time to play church. It's
let us go back to him.
To Jacob, I've been delayed.
Jacob says,
by staying with Laban, he's the cause of all my misfortunes. Laban is a cause of all my predicaments.
Ngifuna wena
tela mahasi yaba
kosi yami
tela basha
Gifuna
wena,
Gilambele wena, sikokwami, Gilambele wena.
se prekeso. Masoko prosia. Che vittoria pocosi a pro.
Just give yourself to him. It's me, Lord. It's me. It's me, Jesus. It's me, God. It's me. Possession. We've been running after money. We've been running after cars. We've been running after Lazarus' life. We left you behind. Right now, Lord, we are returning to you. We are so sorry. We render our hearts. We render our souls. We need you. We need you. Like your son on the cross. He said, why you have forsaken me? Now we know why you have forsaken us. Now we are repenting. We need you, God. We need you, Father. We need you, Jesus. We need you, Holy Spirit. We are not running after these things. You said if we desire your kingdom, if we seek your kingdom, all these things, they will be added. They will follow us all the days of our life. Today you have spoken to us. The things that have caused our delay. We see
We love you because you gave us a better job. You gave us better cars. You gave us better things. But today, we gonna love you. With or without, we love you. With or without, because you gave us. When we didn't have that, you still loved us. We didn't know that you loved us. For us, you went through
agony.
We love you, Jesus. We surrender all to you.
We are seeking only you.
Thank you, Father, for reminding us. We are coming back home, Father. We have gone so far, but we are coming back home today. We know your loving hands. We are coming back home. We are coming back with a humble heart. We are coming back home. Sithi asizofela lana. Asizofela lana ikhaya likhona. We are coming back home to where the Father is. Oh, Jesus. me rababa sanda rababo sika rikabayanda lababo sika ribabondo robobo sika lababa sanda. At home there is no judgment. For those who come back home, the Father is ready to embrace us and celebrate with us. We are coming back to you, God, knowing that you are a loving Father, knowing that you are a kind Father. Ribabosha karababasanda. We are taking the garment of judgment, the garment of guilt, the garment of shame. We are coming back to you, God, knowing that you love us dearly, you love us unconditionally. Yes, Lord Jesus, we give you praise. For Rabayanda Labobo Shekere Bebe Sika. Siyabonga Nkulunkulu wethu ongcwele for such a wonderful time to remember who you are and to remember who we are. We are your children, and you gave your life for us. We are your heirs. Sindlalifa zezulu. We are the ambassadors. We stand for the kingdom. We stand for peace. We stand for joy. We stand for love. We stand for who God is. And God is love. And we remember today, Father, there is no place of judgment in our hearts. There is no place of hate in our hearts. There is no place for anger in our hearts. But only love, compassion, peace, and joy that fills our hearts. You said the kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. And today, we choose to rejoice. We choose to rejoice. We choose to be in peace. We choose to do the right thing. For this is the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is on earth. We shall make it known. We shall declare the kingdom of God, even if we haven't spoken a word. But our presence carries the kingdom of God, for we are the children of the kingdom. And the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal, but mighty in God to pull down all the strongholds. We are so grateful, Father, that we are overcomers. We have overcome through Jesus Christ who dwells in us. There is nothing that we need to do except to let this light shine, except to be the salt, except to show and radiate your glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Siyabonga Nkulunkulu wethu ongcwele. Your glory is here. Your power is here. This is the time. This is the time. And we remember who we are. And we remember who you are in Jesus' name. And we are at home. We are at home. And it's good to be at home. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise.
Give him praise.
Suffering. Just celebrate. Just celebrate. We are home. Just celebrate, my friend. Just celebrate.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. We are at home.
Please, can you do better than that?
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes.
You've been longing to do so. Let's make a joyful noise.
What a message. The message that has taken us back to his feet. There will be no more delays. Everything will happen just like
that.
Dr. T.A., come closer, Mama. Can you help us a little bit to understand how to appreciate life, everything that we have? Before we close. Because we have entered a new era. We were in the era of David. The soldier.
Who
was fighting. All his life. He couldn't build. The temple of God. But now we have entered a new era of
Solomon,
where we will have to build, where we have to apply our wisdom, where money will come to us like waters, where things will be brought to us without any sweating. But with the old mentality, we're
going
to be in trouble. Because we're going to chase relationships that are going to be introduced to us. The thing that made the children of Israel to die in the wilderness, you know what was it? It was the old mentality. The mentality of Egypt. They were taken out of Egypt, but Egypt remained in them. We are on a new era. Our mind must change. Our behavior must change. Our speech must change. The things that we used to touch must change. The walk we used to walk must change. The company that we used to have must change, because there is a paradigm shift. There is a quantum leap that has taken place. It's not by man's power. It is by the Spirit of the Lord. We're
going
to be introducing new relationships. Not only locally, even internationally and globally. We're going to be introduced to new people. But we must change our mentality, because we're going to chase those people away. So I want doctor to help us a little bit. Shortly.
Amen.
Amen.
Uthu baba, he wants, ngiyabonga baba. Greetings to apostle. How do we appreciate life, Lasikon?
How to see to the land and below wherever we are.
Number one, in the lang celebrating Gale Corner, just to confirm what the apostles were saying here. Uguti, the message that God is speaking right now is that we must come back home. We must return to the Father. Okay, sorry. So now, when we are born, we are born being aligned with God. Every child that exits the woman's womb is aligned with God. But when we are born, then we are conditioned by things that people say and the things that we observe. The cultures, everything that we are told, the wrong and the right. And then that is where we begin to move away from God. And we follow the teachings of men. Depending on how far he goes until again he comes back home by receiving Jesus Christ. When a person receives,
for a person to be born again.
Uthi ngazalwa kanjani ngabusha ngoba ngimdala.
Can I be born again because
for
I'm
me,
old?
Just to give you just an interpretation, ukuzalwa kwabusha is new, to become a totally new person.
To be born again ukuba umuntu
omusha. A person that has never been seen.
Umuntu ongakaze abonwe.
That means my husband must see a new person, new behavior altogether, new speech, new conduct, new mindset.
Ukukhuluma okusha nomqondo omusha.
The person that has never existed.
Umuntu ongakaze nje abe khona.
That is coming back home.
Obuyela ekhaya.
Going back to the father.
Obuyela kubaba.
But sometimes because of life.
Ngesinye isikhathi ke because of life.
Some of us don't repent quickly, don't get go back home quickly and we go so far.
Abaphenduki ngokusheshsha babuyela ekhaya bahamba kakhulu.
Abanye up to the point of death.
Abanye baze bafe.
But now when I can give you an analogy ukuthi when you look at the clock at 12 o'clock that is where we are with God. But we walk so far like 3 2 1 3 4 5 6 and 6 is very far where you have separated yourself away from God. But the time that we are in now is where we look at ourselves as the prodigal son and we look at how far we've been away from God. It's an individual decision. It's easy jobasi lana ukuthi yeah but when you go home you need to do this as an individual. It's not somebody that is going to be imposed on anybody else. It's like father change me. And then where you are standing at 6 and we say father I want to come back home. Ngaso sonke isikhathi baba there's this song it says so I'm coming back home. Home angilazi tilthini kodwa mase qhubeka angilazi icula na ubani. But we need to go back to city 7s. 8, 9, 10 and then we need to go back to 12. Even his car is 12 o'clock.
Even the time that we are at is going to 12 o'clock.
So whoever is not returning back will feel the intensity of not being aligned in because the time is close. Everything about the time says back to God, back to God, back to the Father. And those who resist, they will feel it in themselves ukuthi I'm resisting something that is supposed to be done.
Ngoba yonke into ithasibele uNkulunkulu kodwa laba banqabayo bazoza ukuthi bayaphikisana nento ekufanele yenzeke.
So appreciation is one of those things that we need to do.
Ukuthokozela into ekufanele siyenze.
To put ourselves back to God.
Ukuyibuyisela kuNkulunkulu.
Appreciation, what is appreciation?
Yini ukuthokoza?
Appreciation is not when you, I give you 1,000 rand and then you start rejoicing. But the appreciation that we are talking about is the appreciation that is unconditional. That begins with what you have. With that begins with what is happening in your life. So
whatever situation that you are facing in your life,
just thank God.
What you are facing and what he's doing for you.
Sometimes it's funny zindlu, funny mod.
Sometimes you are looking for houses
but
and
your
cars.
Spirit is in bitterness and anger and judgment. And you fail to see God has kept you. You fail to see that God is giving you breath. You are not fighting so much. You have hands that you can lift in worshiping God. You have eyes to see. Some people are asking for those things. But the appreciation which is the best is when you appreciate God for who he is. Not for what he has done and not for what other people has done. But for the fact that he is God. Once we reach
that appreciation,
even
when you see other people, you thank God by
then you have put yourself in the right place. When
you appreciation, in actual fact, when
you are gratitude
and gratitude,
ilakusuke ubeka khona nomzimba wakho ukuthi uhilisheke
ilake your body will start to heal
even inhliziyo yakho
even your heart
iyahilisheka
to heal
even izinto ezinhle
even the good
ziyaqala zize kuwe
start to happen
zikulandele
and they follow
mase sithi buka kokuhle nomusa kuyangilandela because already you have placed yourself la ubonga khona
ngoba uyibeke in a place where you appreciate
now how do we do this kukhona zonke lezi zinto eziningi ezenzakala
now how do we do this while these things
there mhlawumbe uzosho ukuthi anginayo imali
maybe you'll say I don't have money
omunye uzothi mhlawumbe izinto zami they are about to be repossessed
the other one will say izinto zami izodliwa
mhlawumbe abantwana bayangihlupa
maybe my children
now you need to take back yourself uthi kanhlehle kokuqala uNkulunkulu ngubani
now you need to know who God is
because if usafuna ukuyilwela wena ngamandla akho it becomes difficult really even to appreciate
on your own kuzoba nzima
but mawazi ukuthi uNkulunkulu ubani mina kwafinyelela laba bangifinyelela khona ukuthi ngiqale ngibuthi konje uNkulunkulu yena ubani kwabanye bethu uNkulunkulu uyibhoyilethe lisinikeza izibusiso masifuna
I read to the point where I ask who God is cause
iboyile cause umhloko ngiphilise masuphilisiwe ngqasho uyahamba yokwenza into ofuna ukuyenza
they just ask God for whatever they want and they
but when we correct the that you have ngonkulunkulu
kodwa masiqale sizifundisayo ngonkulunkulu ubani
my god you know you have to discover this for yourself
faneke ukutholeke lokho
wena because even me maybe if I can explain it to you who God is to me maybe it won't make sense
kuwe nangeke kwenzeke
you need to define it for yourself
faneke ukwazi
because once why define
ngoba uma kwamchaza
ngeke uphinde utatazele
you will never panic
yabona ngikhona ngitatazeli
where I am I do not panic
I know my god loves me
yazi ukuthi uNkulunkulu
I know his eyes are always upon me I know that he's carrying me in the palm of his hand. I know ukuthi ayisoze yamphunyuka.
I know that
as long as I am content me. No kwenzakalayo mhlawumbe kubhlungu around my life. It's just him telling me
uyena ngitshela.
Ngiyakushape my girl.
I am shaping you my girl
for a better position.
Ukuzume endaweni engcono.
For a better season. Ukuzube ready lezi zinto engikuyisa kuzona.
Jongo Joseph. I'm leading you.
So define mafethu for yourself futhi uNkulunkulu uba.
Zichazele wena ukuthi
amazi uthi mkhulu kangakanani
once you know how great he is
oh my goodness angikwazi baba kuyisho ngamazi lento
I can't
but when you discover who God is
kodwa umeke wazi ukuthi uNkulunkulu ubani
you will appreciate everything that comes into you
uyothokozela yonke into ezimpilweni
because uzokwazi ukuthi ayikho into eyenzeka empilweni yakho eyiphutha
because you will know there is nothing
eyenzeka yena engabonanga
without him seeing it
sometimes he esibonisa kaboni
sometimes you think
then mawucabanga ukuthi akaboni
if you think
you haven't defined him kahle empilweni but uma wazi ukuzela kalala
if you know that it doesn't
akasozangishiya akasozangilahla
of a sake
futhi yena udala izulu nomhlaba
he has created heaven and earth
wadala even ama cells lawe engakwazi ukwachaza ukuthi asebenza kanjani wadala inhliziyo
created the heart
wadala ukuthi umuntu ukufuna lazalo omunye umuntu
created for a person
wadala ukuthi ithambo likhule
and created the bone
inelikwazi ukungisustain
strong and be
wadala ingqondo
created
nami engakwazi ukuyicomprehend
that I can't comprehend
wenza yonke into yaxhumana wadala imbewu ukuthi noma ingahlala kwishalofu
even if it
kodwa wayifaka emhlabathini izokwazi ukuthi ikhiphe siphi isihlahla
put it into the soil you will know what
this is amazing God
uNkulunkulu
manje wadala ilanga
he created the sun
eliphumayo
that comes
elingakaze lithi ngikhathele mina kuphethwe
iqolo
kodwa zonke insuku uhlale
likhona
wadala ama seasons ahlale khona sonke isikhathi azathi nguyena izolo namuhla naphakade njengoba ubonela ngaliphuma lize liyoshona nami nginjalo
this is amazing ongumangalisa
wadala izulu wadala ama planet ebesingawazi ukuthi akhona wanikeza ukuhlakanipha ukuthi ngikwazi ukusuka ngiye ku moon
to be able to go to the moon
banjani labantu
how are these
abakwazi ukwenza iphuphutheki
who are able to
abazi ukuthi ngandizeke akuhlale emoyeni
so that you can fly
konke lokuqhamuka kubani
where does it come from
Jehovah ngimkhonza
Jehovah that I'm saying
so I think when you can discover who God is
ngicabanga ukuthi mongasibona ukuthi
and then you realize ukuthi who God is you are
mase wazi ukuthi lokuNkulunkulu ayikona uyikona
the deal
you are done
then was satisfied wena ngoNkulunkulu
wase wayigcwalisa with God
wazazi ukuthi ungubani
no who you
why align completely 100% naye
align yourself completely
why zithanda wena why appreciate
love yourself and appreciate
then who you are will reflect on how you love other people
lokho kuyikona kuzoyiveza ngendlela othanda abanye abantu
ngayo I think sengikhulume kakhulu baba
I have spoken well
You
have spoken as if you were at Umlazi. The apostle Mlambo, the way he has spoken. Isn't it so
interesting? There are things that we need to teach you. First of all, we started about Ubuti City, pray for wisdom. There are many problems that are going to be there in the world. But listen,
but these problems, they are forcing us to have solutions. For us to have solutions, we need wisdom. It might happen that the way we do things before
change,
even the syllabus is going to change itself.
Because
there are things. You see, on earth,
they industrial revolution.
Spoken about fourth
already
industrial revolution.
Push a five industrial revolution.
Already they want to put the fifth one.
Gune six and seven industrial revolution.
There is a sixth and the seventh.
By our push.
They are pushing them.
Mauso buga sisuga with third industrial revolution sisa with fourth.
When we're coming from the dead, coming to the fourth.
Almost it's more than 100 years.
It took 100 years.
But uksuga with fourth industrial revolution.
But from fourth industrial revolution.
Ogia with fifth industrial
to
revolution.
The fifth one.
Maybe it will take maybe 4 decades.
Maybe it's for 40 years. 40 years.
So these things,
the things that are taking place,
they are almost the same as the church in the spiritual life. So we as the church, we need to understand, we need to be educated, we need to be empowered so that we can handle. Let me tell you the truth.
When
says,
things going to be corrupt, we need to be ready. That's when things are corrupt, what are we going to do? We are crying because of coronavirus.
There
is something beyond coronavirus. What are we going to do when it comes? Now we need to be trained. The first thing that we should pray for is the wisdom. We have prayed for the 19th. We pray for power. We have prayed for the statue. We have prayed for prophesying.
And
all these other gifts that are
said,
we were not able to manage them, some of us. Some, they just become famous and they are famous. They destroy the lives of other people. They have destroyed the families of other people.
So,
now we need to receive wisdom. No matter how anointed you are, but be able to manage
it.
No matter what gift you have, but be able to manage
it.
No matter how powerful you are, but don't force people to eat
food.
But manage
power.
Even if you can wake up in the morning, you are a millionaire. But being able to manage
your millions,
destroy, then creating
money,
segregating people, yet money is good. It is the solution. People, they have failed in their
gift.
Some, they have been defeated by their
anointing.
Some, they have been defeated by
their
and they destroy themselves and other people.
So manje,
because we didn't have wisdom. How many people have won lottery? Very few. Some, they've been killed by that money. Once a person is anointed and the gift, then a person will be puffed up. What is this? What is this? Is it not to help these people that you are?
So, manja, we need to train. We have trained your spirit.
See,
You
don't have
God a problem to
fire, but you have a problem to be wise. You are failing to use what God has given. That is why I have told Mom Doctor to teach us how to
appreciate.
You are alive. You are beautiful. Even if you are not
beautiful.
But you fail to
care for the best.
You want to drive
a car.
You think that
driving a expensive car
is the one that's going to make you happy. You eat. You are failing. You want something that you don't have. You are failing to appreciate what you have. You can't live by what God has given you. You think that you'll be able to live when you receive what you don't have. Even if God can give you, you're gonna destroy by what God gonna give you. Have you ever heard that the blessing of turned to be a curse? If a blessing of turned to be a curse, you find the money, and by this money, you cause people to quarrel. Then you select some and you'll tell others, because you've got money. You do whatever for them. The money
is not missing.
You are supposed to unite people, but you segregated them. The blessing is
tempted.
You've got things, but you segregate people. What is in the church right now is wisdom. People are not wise. They are so not wise. They require things that they don't have. They fail to think what they already have. I know as we gonna teach you like this, some they will think that we are no longer on fire. To be on fire, it's very easy. You kneel down, then you are in the spirit. You sing, then you are in the spirit. To receive wisdom, to apply wisdom, calls a man. People are
children.
They enter into marriage and destroy their marriage. What causes him to destroy their marriage? It because they are not sane, because they are not wise. If they were wise,
maybe 5 years, 10 years later,
then he will rediscover after 10 years. He said, if I was taught, I wouldn't done what I done. She was taught, but she said, no, this is not for me. I think you have received a lot. Let me say this. The syllabus is huge. We might talk about the things that we're going to talk about. But the things that we're going to talk about are the things that
are
going to usher you in the era that you are already in. This era, it's
going
to make you to use your mind and apply those things of the Spirit. Just imagine. If God says to Jeremiah, I'm going to take them through the wings of the eagle from all the corners of the world. Then there was a Wayans brothers who created the aeroplane.
After 2,000 years,
or 3,000, there were people who wanted to
create this thing
that God has spoken about 3,000 years ago. They were required to be wise. The day they created the aeroplane, they created it on another province. But when they caused it to fly, they sent it to another province, because there is a different air there. They were supposed to shift the place so that they are
going to pass.
It would have failed if they have caused it to fly in the place they have created.
Position,
for you to go to another position, you need to shift your focus.
And we are here to do so.
Sila ukwenza logo.
Your mind
needs to be
saved.
There are things that you need to
sake.
We need to build. David wasn't able to build the temple.
But
Solomon he created the temple.
And we are going to build our lives. And the boost of Vugo Soma business.
And the businessmen and ladies gonna rise up here.
We will use every skill, we will empower you. Yes, we face now we era rule.
I know that in the last phase and last era, we have taken out the
demons.
Now they are out. We need to develop you.
Develop your character.
Develop your character.
You understand?
Do you understand?
I don't know about Israel.
People of Israel were taken out of
God
Egypt, but they were not developed so that they would be able to take over Canaan. To develop a person, you transform the man. You taught him the new thing. They are coming from the Bible. But they're going to be taught.
We understand.
So that you will understand the way it's going to
be
developed. What Mom Doctor has said, it's from the Bible. After the demon have been cast out, let the character change. Now you are no longer
the demons.
Even your mind is transformed. Yet you are not using the old eye. Now you are using the eye. Stop gossiping. Stop judging people. Just develop your life. You know to deal your life alone. It can take your lifetime. If you are focusing in the life of people, you are delaying yourself. Just forget what people are saying. Just forget what they are doing. What is it that you are doing with him? Just go back. You love God because of what he has done for you, or you just love him because he is your God. Just love him whether he does or doesn't do anything for you. If things haven't taken place in your life, they are still coming. Don't say, God, where were you during corona? He was present. Where was he before you were born? He was existing. Even when you have died, he will be present. I love you so much.
So, let us grow up.
Let us grow up. More especially, we're going to deal with your mind. To be in the spirit, it's very easy. You just live down. You sing the song, you are in the spirit. But to build or develop the mind, it's called the listening skill. Listening to a person who's been educated.
You're
listening to a person who has been into an experience. Then your life will never be the same again.
Amen. Thank you. Announcement.
Announcements.
Amen. So next week is Yakubega. Today we were supposed to have two services, but due to the fact that Abazolana Barichistanga through to the second service, so we are going to say first come, first serve next week. We are not going to register, but whoever comes first will come. If Sekwele, then a person will have to wait and attend the second one, because it's very strenuous for us to deal with registration and then smage amakama njobe in. And also do the regulations of the COVID-19 response is very difficult. What we're going to do, we are going to make it easy for us. Even no matter database, so first come, first serve tomorrow, next week. So come 30 minutes early so that we can be able to do administration so that in Gonzomasiakal. Second service will be determined through the attendance. If the attendance is very low, then it means we'll have to transfer Abazalan to the next week, because Mabe Ufafa Abazalan. I know we are not undermining Utabazolan about five, but we have a working team of about 32 people.